Today I'm going to talk about a death confirmation without doing any investigation. Normally we rush to the hospitals just for the sake of a straight line ECG. In the international guidelines, it's not necessary that a doctor should be the only person to do it. So that means that any healthcare professional like a nurse or a paramedic staff, they can confirm death if they can do it. So every healthcare professional should know how to confirm death clinically or with the physical examination without doing any investigation. Now, a person to be declared as dead should have at least these four features, and all of them should be irreversible. After stating the names of the features, I would be talking in detail about each of them. So the first one is unconsciousness. The person should be unconscious. The second is apnea, absent breathing. The person would not be breathing. The third is no pulses. That means that no circulation, no active blood moving inside their vessels. The fourth is no pupillary light reflex. I would talk about that. And the fifth is that all of them should be irreversible. So now let's come to each of them in detail. Coming back to the first point of unconsciousness. So if a patient is unconscious, you have to confirm this thing with further three things. The first is no response to voice, like you would call their name and they won't respond. The second is no response to touch. You would touch them and they still won't respond. The third is no response to pain as well. So you would give them some pain. Pain is in the form of, it was initially used to do this sternal rub. Sternum is this mid chest bone. So it was used to rub this because it's sensitive to pain, but now it's an obsolete. And now they say that supraorbital pressure should be given to induce pain. So if the patient is unresponsive to all of these three things, that means that the patient is unconscious completely. Now coming back to the second point, the apnea, absent breathing. So how do you confirm absent breathing? It's again with three things. The first is that the patient, normally if a patient is breathing, his chest or tummy, abdomen, they moves up and down with the breathing. So you would see, you would look for that the patient chest or tummy is not moving with the breathing. Now the second thing is that you can come close to them. You can bring your ear close to their nose and mouth. And normally you can just hear this whooshing sound of the breathing when you come close to someone. So you won't listen to that as well. The third is that if you have a stethoscope, you can put that on the chest. And they say that it should be for 30 seconds to 1 minute. And if you do not listen to anything, that means that the person is not breathing. The third was no circulation, no pulses. So normally we check peripheral pulses. The radial pulse is very common, but for that, central pulse is good, like central, the carotid one or the femoral pulse. So how do you palpate the carotid pulse? You see this Adam's apple, this bony prominence in the neck. So if you go little lateral to this bony prominence and dip your two fingers in this area, you would palpate, you would be able to feel a carotid pulse. So again, if you put your fingers for 30 seconds to 1 minute, you won't feel anything, and that means that there is no carotid pulse. You can also double check with the femoral pulse or with the other pulses. So there would be no pulse. That actually means that there is no blood moving inside their vessels. So the heart has stopped and heart is not working. Again, if you have a stethoscope, you can confirm with the auscultatory points that there are no heart sounds. And again, you have to put the stethoscope for 30 seconds to 1 minute. Now the fourth point was pupillary reflex. So normally when you put light on the pupil, it looks wet, it does not look dry. And secondly, the pupil constricts with the effect of light. When you turn, like you bring light from this lateral to medial position, the pupil normally constricts. But the pupil of a dead person is a fixed dilated pupil. It does not respond to the light. It does not constrict. You have to check both the pupil. And secondly, it would be a dry eye. So normally the eye is not dry. You have seen that there is a wet kind of look for the eye. But in case of a dead person, that would be a dry, fixed, dilated pupil.